Hello everyone, this is Hoda Genji and this is the second video of the Dynamo and Revit interaction series. In the last video, we learned how to select the surface of an element in Revit. Now I'm going to show you how we can select the element itself. So how about I go to the Revit tab, selection. The selection tab is a very important tab in Dynamo. That's how Dynamo links to the geometries that you created in Revit. This time, I want to go with select model element. Last time we used select face. Select model element. It's waiting for you to select the element. I'm gonna go with select. And now it allows you to select an element in Revit. Okay. As soon as I click here, this node has some information inside it, and the information is about the element 361797, which is the same element that we used the face of it before. Okay. Still, you do not see the floor in here, you just see the top of floor. If you want to actually create the floor in Dynamo, there is one more step. We need to go to Revit tab, elements, scroll down, element again, and geometry. Now if you connect this element to element.geometry node, it's gonna actually create the floor for you inside Dynamo. Now you see it has a thickness. Okay, this time I want to group these two and I can type floor. Now let's say you wanna select some specific point on the surface of this floor. I showed you how we can use surface.point at parameter. Now let's try another node. I want to go to the Revit tab, selection, and I want to select one point on the surface of this floor, this time in Revit. So if I scroll up a little bit, select point on face. I want to click there, and now if I click select, it's waiting for you to click anywhere on your model. If I click, for instance, here, that point is gonna show up in Dynamo as well. This time you do not have to go with the origin of the surface like surface.point at parameter, but you can go with any point on Revit. I want to create my walls in Dynamo as well. I can go to the Revit tab again, select, select model element, maybe this time I can select this wall, and I need element.geometry again, Revit elements, element again, and element geometry. Or you can just type element in the text box. So you see, when I connect this, it's gonna create the wall inside Dynamo. I can group this. This is my wall, 18 by 5 meter. Now, if you want to select all the elements which are defined as the same type in Revit, there is another item that you can use in Dynamo. For instance, let's say I want to select all the walls for some reason. So this time I want to use all elements of category. And it's waiting for you to assign a category. So I'm also going to click on categories. And if you click here, you see everything that you have in Revit, any categories are also here. How about I go with walls and assign this category to all elements of category. And if I pin this item, you see this time two walls are selected because I have only two walls in the Revit file. Okay, now you can group this as wall category. Next, I created some windows in my Revit file, and automatically the windows punch the wall, and you see the wall is also updated in Dynamo. This time I want to try to select all the windows in one click. So I can go to Revit, selection. You know the windows are families. So if I go with all elements of family type, it's waiting for you to assign a family type. I can also bring family types. I know this window is 14 by 1800 and it's a casement double window. If I connect this to family type, you see all five windows are selected. So this time this selection is about window, which is a family selection, so select by family. These numbers that you see here refer to the ID of the window. If I click on the window and go to manage and show ID, that's the same number that Revit uses to know that element. Now you see in this wall, we just have punches for where the windows go. If you really want to create the window in Dynamo as well, just like before, we can go to Revit, elements, scroll down, element again, geometry. And if I connect the window selection, all elements of family type to element, it's gonna create them in Dynamo. So now the windows are created in Dynamo. Let's say I want to find the exact location of the origin points of the windows. In this case, I can go back to Revit tab, elements, get location. Okay, and if I connect my windows to elements, if you see here, how about I hide this for a second? Okay, you see it created one point at the center point or the origin of the windows. So if you are designing this wall in Dynamo and you want to be able to work with the windows as well, this is how you can find the exact location of the windows. If I click here and pin this, you see the XYZ of all the windows. For instance, you see the sill height or the Z value is 0.9. Now I want to try to get more information about all the windows that I have in Dynamo. Okay, so I want to show you another item under the same element tab, which is get parameter value by name. Okay, so if I assign elements to element, I also need to provide another input, which is the name of the parameter. If I go back to my Revit, you see, for instance, we have sill height here. So if I want to get the sill height of all the windows in my Revit file, in this case we have only 5, but if you have a complicated file, you might have 100 windows, right? Let's say you want to get the sill height of all of them. You can go with element.getParameterValueByName, and I need to assign a parameter name. I want to type string in the text box. A string is basically a letter or a combination of letters. In Dynamo, it knows that as a string. And if I type the exact same thing that you see in Revit properties, such as sill height, to parameter name, it's gonna give me the sill height of all the elements that I have, which in this case is only 5. The tricky part here is that you have to go with the exact same spelling of the parameter that you're looking for. For instance, if it's sill height, you should be very specific about it. Let's say I want to get the head height, right? I can go back here and type head height. Be very specific, very precise about the spelling. And it's gonna give me the head height of all the windows that I have in my Revit file.